Hi everyone, I am Priyanka and I am a makeup artist. Today I will show you all the makeup products that you need in your kit as a beginner. This video is specifically for oily and combination skin people. I will make another video for dry skin people recommending all the makeup products. So let's get started now. If your moisturizer is good and you don't feel the need to apply the primer, then you can completely skip it. If you have open pores, then I would recommend you to use this Mars primer. It's a pore filling primer and it also mattify the skin, so it works the best for oily skin people. It has a gel-like texture. Just simply take it on back of your hand and dab it wherever you have open pores. I don't know if you can see in the camera, but it literally mattifies the skin and helps in controlling the oil production throughout the day, which makes your makeup last longer. Coming to the concealer, this one from Maybelline Fit Me is one of my favorite. If you will go back and watch my videos, I have been using this for quite a long time. I use the shade Honey because it has orange undertone to it and it works really well in covering the mild pigmentation. So if you have a whitish skin tone with mild pigmentation, then you can try this shade. I'm sure this is gonna work for you. This is actually the new one which I'm opening right in front of you. I have exhausted the old one. This one would be either 5th or 6th tube which I'm using right now. The another good option that I have is from Suze Beauty. I have the shade number 03, which I personally prefer using it only when I have to highlight my face. This is a hydrating concealer, so if you have dry under eyes, this would be a perfect choice. Once you cover your dark circles and pigmentation, and if you don't feel the need to apply the foundation, then you can completely skip it. For everyday looks, you can either use BB or CC cream, or you can also use skin tints, or you can take a little bit of foundation and mix it with your moisturizer and you will have your own skin tint to apply. If you are looking for a medium coverage foundation which will work for oily skin, then I would recommend you to use this one from Nykaa. I swear this product is underrated. It is literally a dupe of Mars tinted moisturizer. The coverage is medium, but you can build it up according to your preference. You can see in the video that it has covered all my acne marks in just one single application. I am using the shade Warm Nude, which is a perfect match for my skin tone. It's oily skin, so of course we can't get away without setting our face with setting powder. My favorite has to be this one from PAC. It's their HD Translucent Powder, which sets the makeup well, blurs your skin and also control the oil production, which make your makeup last longer. If you want to try this, you can get a mini one which will cost around 225 rupees. Even the small amount goes a long way, so this powder is gonna last for a long time and it would be a perfect addition to your makeup kit. So I explain about this technique in almost all my videos because I personally have oily skin and this technique does wonders for me. Take a powder on a powder puff like this, dab the excess on back of your hand and then press the powder all over your face. This sets the makeup well, making it last longer. I have set this side of my face with the powder and I hope you can clearly see the difference, how it has mattified my skin and has set my makeup really well. Now if you're someone who doesn't like to apply foundation and stick to their compact powder, then I would recommend you to try this one from Nykaa. This is their oil control face powder with SPF 15. It won't cover your acne marks or pigmentation, but it will mattify your skin. I use this on a regular basis, so you can already see that I have hit the pan. If you have combination skin and you love to wear cream blushes, then you can try this one from Inside Cosmetics. This is their newest launch. I'm using the shade number 5. It's called Floral Fiesta. It's a very peachy kind of a blush. Also, one thing I have noticed while using this blushes is that you can't directly apply it on your face. It becomes really difficult to blend it. So take the product on back of your hand, warm it up there and then apply it on your face for a very smooth application. For powder, blush, contour and highlighter, you can try this Swiss Beauty Chicaboo palette. My favorite is shade number 2. It is perfect for medium skin tone people. The contour and blush is highly pigmented, so be careful when you apply it. Don't take too much of product in one go because then it will become really difficult to blend it. Also, when I bought this palette, I didn't had much of expectation from the highlighter, but this highlighter works the best. It doesn't have very chunky glitters to it. It's very smooth and gives you a very flawless finish. And I feel this would be a perfect highlighter for oily skin people because it gives you a inner kind of a glow. Also, I like this blush from Swiss Beauty. It's in the shade Coral Dream. This has a bit of shimmer particles to it. So if you apply this blush, you don't feel the need to apply the highlighter. For eyeshadows, these two from Swiss Beauty are my personal favorite. It's in the number 04 and 05. I have also created celebrity inspired look using this palette. The shimmer shades in this palette are okayish, but the matte shades are highly pigmented. And I think this would be perfect for beginners. Start with neutral color first and then you can move towards colorful eyeshadow palettes. For casual pencil, I really like this one from Krylon. It's not available on the Nykaa's website, but you can find this on Krylon website, which I'm gonna link in the description box. For a beginner, I feel a black and a brown kajal pencil is enough, so you can give this one a try. Or you have to just warm the tip a little bit on back of your hand and then you can use it for your eyes. Before we proceed, if you're finding this video helpful, I would request you to please subscribe to my channel and like this video so that I can reach more and more people. I wouldn't recommend using liquid eyeliners for beginners because it tends to get messy. You can either use the kajal pencil, which I have showed you. It has brown and black, so you can create your wing liner using both the colors. However, if you want to create a bold eyeliner look, then you can also try this gel eyeliner from Swiss Beauty. It has eyebrow and gel eyeliner, but the eyebrow shade is black, which I don't personally like using it. But the gel eyeliner works the best and it is perfect for beginners as well. For mascara, you can use this one from Maybelline. It's their Colossal Mascara. It gives immense volume to your eyelashes. Just make sure that whenever you are apply it from the roots and not on just the tip. For eyebrow pencil, I really like to use this one from Swiss Beauty. It's their Micro Precision Eyebrow Pencil. And the best part is, it comes with a spoolie. The tip of this eyebrow pencil is so precise that it will help you draw hair-like natural strokes. I'm using the shade 03. Which is natural brown. I just comb my hair in upward direction and then I fill in the sparse area. Like I said, the tip is very fine, so you have to be very careful while using it. Don't press it too hard, just draw the stroke very light-handedly. For lips, I'm wearing the same lip and cheek tint from Inside Cosmetics, which I have showed you in this video, but I also make a lot of shots on just lipstick, so I would recommend you to watch that. For setting spray, I really like to use this one from Swiss Beauty. It does give a dewy finish, so I like to spray it just on side of my face. It has fragrance, so it can irritate your skin, so please avoid this if you're allergic to fragrance. I still have to explore few more options in setting spray from drugstore, so I will keep you guys updated if I find a new favorite. Also, I have made a video for beginners specifically covering all the eyeshadow brushes that I use, which you can watch here. See you there.